low temperature transition, take a sample heated, short transition at high temperature. So you have both sample composition variation as well as thermal treatment variation and changing the resistivity parameters. For these four samples, we looked at the disorder parameter from XFs. When you do that, we find the following result. These are the disorder parameter experimentally obtained from XFs analysis. All of them show the same behavior. They decrease, sort of flatten out, and then again decrease. Okay, all of them behave exactly the same. It turned out that this is the transition temperature. Far away from the transition temperature, both low energy temperature and high temperature end can be fitted with one correlated Debye model plus a static disorder, just like LA-MNH could be done like this. These are fits to the data point far away from the transition region, and it can be described exceedingly well far away from the transition region. The Debye temperature you need for all of them is more or less the same, 380 Kelvin. There's an independent estimate of the Debye temperature in these systems from, I think, sound velocity measurements, which puts it at 400 Kelvin. So it's very close to that estimate. So we believe these dashed lines are meaningful. But we find very strong deviation exactly in the range of the transition, showing that the disorder increases. So the increase in disorder is the difference between the experimental curve and this fit. You find that the disorder increases, becomes maximum, exactly where the resistivity transition takes place, which is the arrow. See that, so the disorder is maximum. And then again drops off. Here this sample was heated and the resistivity maximum was shifted from that temperature to this temperature, and the disorder maximum also shifts to higher temperature. Likewise here, from that temperature to this temperature, you can shift it. Not only that, this, remember, was a broad resistive transition, and there's a much broader disorder parameter, whereas this becomes sharper. Similarly broad and much sharper. So it looks like that the disorder parameter and the resistivity transition are very similar to each other. This is a completely unknown phenomenon. Such a thing has never been seen. Such a strong non-Debye and yet temperature-dependent disorder change, which seems to be correlated with the resistivity, has not been seen before. Nor do we have an explanation what is happening, but this is an observation that tells you it's not only the magnetic and the electronic structure that are interconnected, but also the geometric disorder is very strongly coupled to this electronic and magnetic properties to determine the properties of this system. So let me quickly summarize this, with which I'll finish my 1 hour, and after that stop. What I've shown you, that the lanthanum manganate system doped with strontium is a very unusual system, where you find spectral weight redistributed for a very wide temperature range, wide energy range, with changing temperature, for which I have offered no explanation. We have found that there is a systematic change in the spectral weight at the Fermi energy as we increase the temperature, which is again exceedingly unusual and has never been seen before. We have associated that with a changing correlation strength. I have explained to you that the bandwidth increases as we increase the temperature because of changing magnetic order. In our paper, we have also pointed out, and we can discuss this point if you are interested, that Coulomb strength actually increases as you increase the temperature. So the correlation strength U by W increases rapidly as a function of temperature in this system. Possibly that is what is responsible for removal of spectral weight from the Fermi energy and inducing the metal to insulator transition. Also remember that this explanation of ours is consistent with the giant magnitude resistance property, because close to the TC where your spin moments are disordered now, you have high resistivity, low spectral weight at the Fermi energy. If If we apply a magnetic field, what would happen?